Welcome to episode number 9. In this episode, we will talk about what is a control valve. So let's get started. Basically, a control valve is an instrument used in factories or plants. It is an instrument that controls the flow of a fluid in a passage. It's done by varying the size of that passage. Main parts are body, actuator, and positioner. This is the body of the valve, which is the mechanical valve itself. This is the actuator, which is in this case a motor or an electric actuator, and this is here the positioner, which is what we will talk about in next slides. Control valve has this symbol, and this is the control valve itself. Now, it increases or decreases the fluid flow path size in order to control flow rate, as we explained in the previous slide. Now, control system actually sends a control signal to the valve. It tells it to open or close, or fully open or fully close. It's an analog signal basically, and according to that, the control valve opens or closes. So now some control valves have a manual override option, which is useful when there is a problem in automatic positional control. This is what we talk about. This is a manual override switch or a controller. It is basically when your control valve accepts signals, but it doesn't work due to any malfunction. You use this one to fully open or fully close the valve. Now, the valve body. The valve body is basically the valve itself, the mechanical valve. It is of many types, such as a globe valve, butterfly valve, ball valve, diaphragm valve, or gate valve. It is due to many types of processes in factories, or basically some of them can withstand a process, some of them can't. But basically the most famous one are butterfly valves and maybe ball valves. But all of them are well used. The valve actuator. Now, what is the actuator? It is a mechanical assembly or a device that directly controls the opening or closing of the valve body. So it has three types: electrical, hydraulic, or pneumatic. It depends on the type of power it uses. Now, the hydraulic ones, such as a piston type, which is a piston operated by hydraulic power, it is very rare compared to the other ones. The electrical one is a kind of modern one, but the most famous one is the pneumatic one, which uses pneumatic or air pressure signals, such as a diaphragm valve. Now, the diaphragm pneumatic actuator. This is what is inside this plate right here. The diaphragm is like a rubber or an elastic material. An air just flew in this hole right here and pushes it along with the spring down. Now, with this being pushed down, the valve itself, or the globe valve in this drawing, is pushed down or is pushed up according to the air supplied. Now, this spring is acting as some kind of reverse mechanism. So when you remove air, this spring, by the power of it, it returns the control valve to the fully open or fully closed, depending on the system. Now, the diaphragm, as we said, is an elastic material. This is called a single acting because there is only one air supply. There is also the double acting, which has another one right here, which is called double acting, which has input and another input to determine the position. Now, the positioner is the device that gives control signals for the actuator. And tells it to make sure it moves it to the desired position and maintains it there. So if you want the valve 40% open or 40% closed, the positioner sends the actual air signals or control signals to the actuator so that it achieves this percentage and maintains it no matter what. It has an air supply input, for example, a 6 bar, and a pneumatic control signal, which is 3 to 15 PSI, which is an industry standard. And also it has an air output, which goes to the actuator. So basically an input, an output, and a control signal. Now, the 3 to 15 PSI air signal is taken from the I to P converter, which in turn takes the 4 to 20 milliamps control signal from the PLC or any control system such as a DCS, and then converts it to 3 to 15 PSI. The I to P converter is the current to pressure converter. It takes the industry standard 4 to 20 milliamps current signal and converts it to the 3 to 15 PSI air pressure signal that the control valve positioner accepts. Now, some modern positioners have the I2P input, the I2P unit built in. So the user just feeds the 4 to 20 milliamp signal to it directly. And finally, we finish with the drawing of the control valve. This is the body itself, this is the positioner, and this is the actuator. And this is, of course, the rest of the assembly with some gauges around. Now, this is the input pressure. For example, this can be 6 bars, 10 bars, whatever available. And this device right here is called a supply regulator, a pressure regulator. For example, if you have something like 12 bars right here, and your control valve operates at 6 bar, you put a 6 bar pressure regulator to just feed the 6 bar input. And this is here the control signal, which is the 3 to 15 PSI, and this is a gauge. It is just a visual representation. Now, this particular control valve is a double acting one. How did I know that? Because it has its positioner has two outputs, one which is down and two which is up. So one here and one here. To each one there is a gauge, and to each one it goes to a different side. Now, it is worth mentioning that most positioners has some kind of this configuration, 3 or 4 gauges. One for supply, one for the input command, which is the 3 to 15 PSI pressure signal, and one for the output itself. The output can range from 0 bar to 6 bars of the input. So it is not 3 to 15 PSI. It is 3 to 15 PSI, it is just a control signal. The actual air pressure that flows in here equals to whatever the actuator specifies. So, for example, very, very large control valves may have, may require 10 bar or 6 bar or whatever. Of course, the 3 to 15 PSI is very, very small and it cannot do that. The positioner here takes that as a reference signal, or takes the 4 to 20 milliamps signal as a reference, and then outputs a supply specific for this type of actuator that resembles the percentage that you want to open the, or close the valve at. Now, of course, as any other valves, it has a visual representation of how much you are open or how much you are closed. And of course, it has many types like fully open or fully closed, or for example, if you want it to be normally open or normally closed, and so on. Now, the next episode, maybe I will explain why do we use 4 to 20 milliamps current signal as the default industry standard in plants and factories, and why it is not used in mere electronics. Thumbs up if you want to see that. And this is the end of this video. I hope you find it good. Thank you for watching, and we will meet again when I return in another episode. Thank you for watching.